What's up, guys? Jimmy or Gauss, welcome back. And you've probably heard about the multiplayer maps that are coming for DLC 3 and Black Ops 3, but I wanted to focus a little more on one specifically. Real quick, let's just go over the maps. The first one, Empire, is the remake of Raid, which probably is the most anticipated map so far this year for Black Ops 3, and it's their reimagining of Raid. The question is, how is it going to play with the new movement, with the wall running? And Vonderhaar actually even tweeted that it is going to be fast. So it's going to be really interesting to see this one. The next one is Cryogen, which is located in the Dead Sea, or right off the Dead Sea. It's an isolated compound that holds some of the world's most dangerous criminals in frozen isolation. I'm hoping maybe there are some Easter eggs in here. Maybe we see some frozen criminals that are actually like movie stars or movie references that we've seen in the past. Remember the movie a long time ago, Judge Dredd, where they were all frozen? Just hopefully there's something cool. It sounds like a really cool map. There's actually sentry towers in here, and it should be pretty interesting to see how this one plays. And the next one is Berserk. Ancient sentinels from a lost civilization guard entrance to Berserk. It's a Viking village, which I don't know if we've ever seen a Viking theme mapped in Call of Duty. This may be a first. You have to fight through blizzards, which makes me wonder, is there dynamic weather, or is it just going to be a constant, like, blizzard effect while you're outside? We'll have to wait and see. And this one is a medium-sized map with tons of tight choke points. But the one I want to focus on is Rumble. Gamers battle against larger-than-life mechanized warriors in Rumble, or mechs. If you remember the movie Real Steel, where the robots used to fight each other, that's what comes to mind to me. And I'm assuming, they say it's a medium-sized map, I think it may play more like a small to medium map, and it's going to have that center focus of the arena, of course. And it says players will battle their way through fallen mechs in pyrotechnics. The medium-sized map funnels high-speed combat to the central arena, and it kind of reminds me of like a stadium just by listening to the description, which I hope, I know it's not a remake of Stadium, but I hope that it plays kind of like that. And I'm wondering, in the beginning, they say gamers battle against larger-than-life mechanized warriors. I know that doesn't mean we're battling against them, but are they active and part of the map? Do they play a role somehow in this Rumble map, or are they just there for cosmetic looks? I think it would be awesome if these things somehow played a role in the map. I don't know how, but somehow dynamically, and I know that's not really Black Ops 3's thing, that's not really what they're focused on, or Treyarch's focused on, is dynamics in the game. But it's going to be interesting, because that first statement does kind of tease that you're going up against these large mechanized warriors, which are going to be, look from the picture, it looks like these things are going to be huge. And I know that probably, more than likely, 99% doesn't mean anything about the gameplay in the map, but it would be really cool if somehow they were interactive with you. But to me, this one out of these four has the potential to be something really, really cool. They all sound cool. The Viking Village sounds really cool. We know Raid is going to be something that everybody's excited about, but I just think Rumble, if it's what I'm thinking it's going to be, if it plays kind of like the stadium map from Black Ops and everybody funnels to the center and you have these giant mechs in the middle and it's fast-paced, medium-sized, but feels a little smaller than that, that could be the one that pops out as the fan favorite. We'll have to wait and see. You guys let me know which one are you most looking forward to, aside from Empire, because obviously it's Raid. Everybody wants to see that one. But out of the other three, Cryogen, Berserk, and Rumble, which one do you think will actually come off as a fan favorite? But let's face it, maps in DLC go one way or the other. They're either really popular or people don't really want to play them. There isn't really that much of a middle ground, it doesn't seem like. It's like, I'll vote for this or I won't vote for this. So let me know what you guys think. Hope you have a great day, and I'll see you later.